Right, here we are again with part three of my GameCube collection, so let's get straight to the games. First one is Mario Party 4. Of course, Nintendo have been churning out these Mario Party games for quite some time and shown no sign of stopping now, but number four is the only one that's in my collection. There are some fun little mini games in there. Only really worth playing if you've got some people to play it with. Yeah, that's all I have to say about that, really. Next, we have Metal Gear Solid: The Twin Snakes. I checked out eBay recently to see how much this goes for nowadays, and I was quite shocked to find that it often sells for about 50 quid. It is basically a remake of the original Metal Gear Solid, with slightly improved graphics, extended action cutscenes directed by a Hollywood choreographer, can't remember his name, and it's been Nintendoized in several ways. For example, in the fight with Psycho Mantis, he reads your memory card, and on the PS1 he comments if you've been playing certain Konami games, but in the GameCube version he comments if you've been playing stuff like Super Mario Sunshine or Luigi's Mansion, for example. So if you're a fan of the Metal Gear Solid series, I recommend picking it up. It's not necessarily better than the PS1 original, but it's different enough to be worth a look. Next, another NTSC game, Metroid Prime. This is possibly my favourite game of all games on the Cube. I've never really got into the Metroid series, the 2D games, but this is just a fantastic sort of first-person adventure. Yeah, it definitely needs to be in your collection if you haven't got it. Next is Metroid Prime 2 Echoes. Not as good as the first Metroid Prime. The light and dark world mechanic got to be a bit annoying, and there's some rock hard bosses in here. But again, it's a pretty good game, so worth checking out also. NBA Street Volume 2 by EA Sports Big. I was quite a basketball fan. I haven't watched it for a long time, but this is a enjoyable arcade basketball game, in the tradition of stuff like NBA Jam. There's some cool game breaker moves that you can inflict on your opponents, and a very good soundtrack. So, yeah, it's a fun little game. Next, I have Pac-Man World 2, which comes with Pac-Man Versus, and the Pac-Man Versus is the main reason I bought this. It's a player's choice disc, so it wasn't very expensive. But Pac-Man World 2 is actually a decent little platformer in its own right, so yeah, it's a good solid disc. Next, actually, I said Metroid Prime was probably my favourite game on the GameCube, but actually, thinking about it, this game has to take the crown. It's Paper Mario: The Thousand Year Door, follow up to Paper Mario for the N64, of course, featuring Mario himself, and yeah, it's just an awesome, funny little RPG. The first two Paper Marios are fantastic games. I was a little disappointed personally with the route that Nintendo took with Paper Mario for the Wii, because it's basically gone away from the RPG elements and become more of a a platformer, and the RPG was why I really liked the games in the first place. So, but yeah, that's an awesome game, and I'm gonna have to replay it again soon, I think. Next, we have the first Pikmin. Really innovative little title this was, but the only drawback was with this was the rather harsh 30 game day time limit, so you feel rushed all the time, and if you mess up a few times, then it can be hard to collect all the ship parts that you need. This was fixed to some degree in Pikmin 2. This added little white poisonous Pikmin, which can be sacrificed by feeding them to enemies and poisoning them, and little purple strong Pikmin. And yeah, and it dropped the time limit of the first game, and it's got a surprisingly good multiplayer mode this time around. I would recommend picking this up. I got this one as part of my subscription to the official Nintendo magazine, actually. They were giving it away for a little while with new subscriptions, so that's how I've got my copy. Next, we have the GameCube remake of Resident Evil. I'm a big fan of the Resident Evil series, and this remake is fantastic. Looks amazing. Adds quite a few little changes to the original game, including extra areas to explore, little bits of extra storyline. The dialogue has re been re-recorded, so the cheesiness of the PS1 game has been reduced. Of course, that's what makes the game so enjoyable to some people, that the rather rubbish acting and dialogue of the first game. But yeah, it's a fantastic game. Just been rather pointlessly re-released on the Wii, if you ask me, because you can play this game on the Wii anyway, so there was no need to re-release it. And now we have another Resident Evil game, Resident Evil 0. This is set before the original Resident Evil, and stars Rebecca Chambers and some bloke I can't remember the name of, Billy something. And it takes place on a train and a scientific research facility. It's not as good as other games in the series, but better than stuff like Dead Aim and Outbreak, at any rate, so could be worth picking up if you see it for cheap. And one more game for this part, and then I'll have to do a fourth part. More Resident Evil. This, of course, is Resident Evil 4, so the NTSC version. What can I say? This is the best game in the Resident Evil series, if you ask me. I have played a little bit of 5 and didn't really like it. I mean, this is just so full of fantastic set pieces. Every stage is memorable. It's quite a replayable game as well, because encounters with the enemies never goes the same way twice, in my opinion. Yeah, a must play in the series. So that's it for part 3. I'll see you again for the fourth and final part.